Hello and welcome to the European Pin Briefing for Monday, January the 7th. This is Marios Hatzoukiriakos, Investment Analyst at Exam, and we're going to be looking at the latest developments in the financial markets today. Let's start with the major moves that we saw in stock markets and the US dollar on Friday. So initially, the dollar gained while stocks fell after the US employment report for December beat expectations quite significantly. Specifically, non-farm payrolls rose by an astonishing 312,000, much more than the consensus of 184,000, while wage growth surprisingly reached a fresh decade high of 3.2% in annual terms. However, these market reactions proved short-lived, and the dollar gave back its gains to trade lower while stocks closed much higher after Federal Reserve Chairman Jay Powell appeared quite dovish. He said that the Fed's policy is flexible, implying it can change direction if needed, and that policymakers are listening carefully to the concerns of financial markets. So in essence, Powell signaled that his Fed is prepared to pause rate hikes or even reverse them if the incoming data confirmed the market's fears. His remarks were very beneficial for risk appetite, with stocks gaining in tandem with commodity currencies like the Aussie, as investors priced in Fed rate cuts by this time next year. Stocks were further supported by news that China cut the reserve requirement ratio on commercial banks to boost lending and growth. The real question right now is whether this dovish shift by both the Fed and the People's Bank of China will be enough to stabilize stock markets in general. For now, it doesn't seem quite enough, as markets are still worried about a broader economic slowdown. But if we were to also see some progress in the US-China trade talks, for example, that may do the trick. As for the dollar, today we get the ISM non-manufacturing PMI for December. It's currently at a very elevated level, so if it declines substantially, it could feed speculation that the US economy is slowing down and perhaps hurt the US currency. More broadly, we will also hear from several Fed officials this week, starting with Bostic today, and if they echo Powell's cautious tone, that could also weigh on the greenback. Finally, in the UK, the debate in Parliament about the Brexit deal will begin today, while the vote is set to take place late next week. Thank you very much and have a great day.